Hey guys and dolls, how are y'all today? It is Mama Monday, and as mentioned a couple of days ago, all of this month, so for the next four Mondays, I think there's only four Mondays in this month, we are going to be talking about makeup for all the littles that are over 40, you know, mature, us ladies that have more experience. So guys, this might be a little bit boring for you, so you can move on if you want to. But getting down to the topic of today's Mama Monday makeup stuff, I guess is what we're going to call it, is I finally am getting around to Susan Fisher asked way back when I did a tutorial on the Physician's Formula tutorial, the eyeshadow that I had gotten. She asked, and this was way back in June of this year, asked specifically about a good eyeshadow primer. And so I wanted to talk a little bit about eyeshadow primers. Excuse me, as always, got to itch my nose in every video. I don't know why that is, but I'm not going to edit it, so here we go. So primers in general, okay, those kind of came on the scene real big recently, in recent years. And, of course, my background, you know, I had done modeling and stuff like that. So I was familiar with primers and things like that for photo shoots or for fashion shows or whatever, when you have to have your face just so. But I'll be really honest with you, I rarely, if ever, use primers ever during the day. Because when I put my makeup on in the morning, I can go all day and except, you know, putting on a little bit of more lipstick or blush if it's, you know, 4 or 5 in the afternoon and I've got to go on into that evening doing something. I rarely use a primer because I just don't find the need for them in everyday cosmetics, okay? So unless you're wanting to really be fancy pants or something like that, I think primers are a waste of money, to be all honest with you. However, having said that, I know everybody's skin is different and some people need to use a primer or they feel they need to use a primer because, for example, in the eye area, that's specifically what she asked about, Miss Susan. She was talking about in the, you know, the eyeshadow primer, because I know a lot of people, they have eyelids that produce more oils, which is good because you won't get the crinkly, crepey eyelid, but it can cause eyeshadows to crease a little bit. So here are my suggestions of primers that you can use for just every day, you know, if you want to use that. So, again, primers in general, what are they for? Primers in general, it gives the skin a foundation, if you will, something to allow the makeup to grab onto. In the art world, it's called giving it some tooth. So you would put a matte medium on your canvases or whatever to give the paint some tooth to grab onto. So that's the same you know, premise that primers do now. Now also, if you wash your face and you tone it and you put a moisturizer on, you cannot skip the moisturizer step. Even if you've got oily skin and acne, you cannot skip the moisturizing step, okay? But if you do all that and then begin to put your makeup on, you're going to find you don't need any kind of a primer, okay? So along the lines of that, thinking in that realm, again, this is what I use every day for moisturizing. It's just, it's Simple Brand. This is the Hydrating Light Moisture Moisturizer for sensitive skin, okay? So the wonderful thing about this is that it doesn't have any kind of irritants. So in this case, what you would do for your eyeshadow, as an eyeshadow primer, and again, you use your ring fingers, not these because there's too many muscles in it, and not that one. Use your ring finger, and literally, you want to put just the tiniest amount, and I can't even get it to come out. There we go. Right there. Can y'all see that? The tiniest, tiniest drop. There it is from the side, so you can see literally how small it is. And then just rub your fingertips together until it almost feels like you've rubbed it in, okay? And then from here, and I'm not going to do it because I have eyeshadow on, but from there, you're just going to literally go in little semicircles from the inside of the eyelid out 2 or 3 times. Make sure you get it down, you know, where your eyeshadow is going to stop. So you want to bring it just very lightly right there, okay? And then immediately begin to put on your eyeshadow. Now, that is a moisturizer-based, okay? Now, another thing that you can do, And let me back up here a little bit to give you an idea before I show you this, because some people are going to freak out. This is a little sample that I got from Too Faced, okay? And it is a wonderful primer, and it works really well with their eyeshadows, okay? So the Too Faced is a real good one to do. But I did look on the back, and the ingredients on this, as with other primers as I checked, it has things like talc, which is powder. It has things like mica, which is a powder. And it has things in there listed that are like lanolin, which is a moisturizer, and like petroleum-based products, which are a moisturizer. Okay? So this product I've shown you before, but again, it works excellent as an eyeshadow primer. I've used this, obviously, as a primer, and I've used this as an eyeshadow primer. This is nothing but petroleum jelly. It's Vaseline brand. No, I don't get paid for any of this. No, none of this is sponsored. So again, now, don't go crazy with this stuff, okay? You don't need globs of it. Just like I showed you the little bitty drop here, same thing with this, okay? You get it, get that fingertip, and literally, watch what I do. I literally touched it. I didn't scrape it in there. I touched my fingertip to it. I don't know if y'all can see that at all. I'm going to put my hand up so where maybe you can see on this finger. That's it, okay? It's just to moisten it. And then again, you do like this, and then the same motion here again. Now, this one will be one that's a little bit more long-lasting because it is a petroleum-based product. Now, a lot of people freak out about petroleum-based products. I understand, okay? But I have to say this. I've been using this. I had used it for years for makeup removal. No eye problems. I'm 45. Don't have a lot of the bad wrinkles. So you be the judge. And it's like I always tell everybody, don't believe a word I say. Do the research yourself, okay? Now, this morning, actually, and I'm going to close my eyes so y'all can see, that was put on this morning at about 10 o'clock, 10:30 this morning, and it is right now 5 o'clock. And I've been out in 103-degree temperatures today running errands. So you can see how it is, and it's just two colors on there. It's just a shell color and then brown in the crease, okay? Now, what I actually did with this, and I did it on purpose to see how it would work. This is actually from Physicians Formula as well, and it's part of a pair, but I just wanted to show you this part. But what this is called is Mineral Wear Talc-Free Mineral Correcting Concealer. It's actually concealer in pink highlighter is what the name of the color is, all right? Now, again, as you remember, any kind of eyeshadow primer or face primer, it's to give tooth, right, to the product so it'll stay on there longer. When you do that, it is going to intensify the color a little bit, and the blendability is much more of a challenge, okay? So you're going to have to blend, blend, blend. Like with this brown right here, normally if I don't have a primer on, I can just blend it and it's done. But this, I really had to get in there and blend it, because once it's on, it doesn't want to move. And that's the beauty of a primer, is that it makes the makeup stay where it is, okay? So I actually used this today because I thought, I wonder what that'd look like. And so it turned out good, and so it's funny that I chose to do that today. But this, you can see it's just like a little, it looks almost like, because it is concealer, it's like a little concealer sponge. But let me show y'all, I guess here on the back of my hand. And I'm just kind of doing a little bit. But I loved the color of it, and I thought, well, I'm just going to use this like an eyeshadow. Can y'all see that? That's the color of it, okay? And the shell color I was going to put on was pink anyway. It was a very light, almost a white color pink. And I thought, well, why not? So I did that first. And again, I don't want to get too close because I know it gets out of focus. But I used this first as the primer, okay? I used this first. And then I did the shell color. And then I did the brown on top of it. And actually, the colors are from the Too Faced palette, the matte palette that I did a tutorial on before. So now with this, it was sticky because it, you know, it doesn't dry immediately, but that was appealing to me because once I put on the powder, it stuck onto that. And as you can see, there's no creasing, okay? And so it lasted a good long time. Now, this was something I had. If y'all have been around any at all, you've seen me do tutorials on this a long time back. And then, of course, this stuff is what I use just normally. So those are, you know, I'm never one to, hey, let's go spend lots of money on things. And if I can find something alternate instead of something expensive, I'm definitely going to tell y'all about it. So this in general, for your skin in general, but it works great as an eyeshadow primer as well. This is wonderful. It gives it a little tooth and it's a little more slick than, say, something like this that does actually have the talc and things like that in it that are going to give it a little bit more of a grip even so. So there you go. Let's see, Miss Susan Fisher. I hope that answered your questions. Y'all let me know in the comments below what eyeshadow primer you use and how you use it, or if you have something like I do where it's alternate of that. Let me know in the comments below how it's working for you. And join me next week for another makeup tutorial or makeup demonstration or makeup something. We'll do something about makeup next week for all of us ladies. And then tomorrow on Talk Show Tuesday, I'm going to be talking about MLM and network marketing. So if that's of interest to you, tune in there. You can find the link to Blog Talk Radio on my YouTube channel page, or you can go to blogtalkradio.com/WesleyGW. So until next time, y'all have a delicious, delightful, delirious day, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.